that is now how the vultures got their, well, the people believe that they can predict the future, because people think, how can a vulture know that there's a way? How do they know? They must be able to predict the future or be clairvoyant or something like that. But it's just that they keep an eye on the other vultures, and then if they start going down and moving in one direction, they follow them. So that is actually the actual behavior, and then the myths that were built around them. Myths in many cases are quite innocent. In this case, can be a bit of a problem, because vulture is also, it's a vulnerable species. Apart from, because the farmers don't like them, they say they eat their sheep, which often is not the case. It happens sometimes, but very rarely. And then sometimes they put poisoned carcasses there. And actually, when the vultures come and eat, they die from that. So they have a difficult already. In addition, because of this belief, the local belief that vultures put, which is the local, I think we'd call it maybe like black medicine or local, the witch doctors, they use vulture brains. And they make a potion from that, and if you drink that or eat that, they believe that then you can also predict the future. And people buy that in the hope that they can predict their lotto numbers and things like that. And that puts even additional pressure on vulture population. So while it is an interesting story and an interesting belief, the consequences can actually for the vulture be quite negative. Yeah, so that's actually what I wanted to tell you about the vultures. It's as I said, fascinating. They have a pecking order. Even before the white-backed vultures, you get the leopard-faced vulture, which is even a lot bigger and has a very, very strong beak. And that can actually tear open the carcass. And that's typically the first one that gets to eat. And then the let's say, medium-sized vultures, like the white-backed vulture, or also the cape vulture, or come. And then, finally, to clean up the last pieces, then the hooded vulture arrives, and really everything. I said, by the time we left, there was absolutely nothing left. No little piece of scrap. Yeah, so much about vultures for now, I think. What I would like to do now, I have some other video of some elephant, which I wanted to play a bit later. But I just want to give it a try and see how many people are in chat and whether there are questions in general. We'll see how that goes. If it works out well, we can spend some time on that. Otherwise, once a week, we'll reserve some time actually to get some questions. The other video is actually just for interest sake, in a sense. Last week I noticed at the waterhole at Gauri, before twice in a row, there was a rhino coming to drink. And just maybe a minute afterwards, or a couple minutes afterwards, a big group of buffalo came and the rhino moved off and let the buffalo drink. And then one time it even stood there for 5 minutes, like 20 meters away, thinking, I wanted to drink, but I was here first. But the buffaloes apparently had a higher rung than the rhino at that point. Even yesterday, when the buffaloes were drinking during the gag, and they actually walked past twice, having a look. The second time they looked past, they walked past closer, but still they never came to drink as they saw the buffaloes there. Of course, you can't say that it was because of that, but it definitely seemed that way. And as soon as the buffaloes moved off a bit later, when Peter came back from his drive, there was an elephant drinking there. So it looks very much like buffaloes are at the top, or at least very near the top, or to say at waterholes. And that reminded me of some footage I shot when I was in Edo Elephant Park last year, October, which also deals with the same thing. And that video is interesting in other senses as well, I think. But it's just an interesting behavioral pattern that's shown there. So I'm not going to introduce it much, but I'm just going to let you show it. It's called bullies. And it shows you that not all can be a bully. Also, the people that are bullied might turn into bullies themselves. Okay, let me start the video. So this was not taken in Gauri here, but something taken at Elephant Park, which is close to Port Elizabeth in the Cape Province. So here's a small family group of elephants, and then a buffalo arrives, just one. And what you can notice is that immediately the elephants all stop drinking, and at first glance there seems to be no threat from the buffalo, it just comes there to have a drink. But the elephants do keep a respectful distance. It really looks like they're waiting for the buffalo to move away, but they're probably too thirsty themselves to to just walk off. As I said, a healthy respect for that one buffalo. At the time I thought maybe they had some bad experience at some time with a buffalo, but the Gowrie waterhole of the last couple of weeks, I'm starting to think that it's like a regular thing, that there's a, if you could call it a hierarchy of species at a waterhole, and surprisingly then, if that is the case, then the buffaloes do rank higher than the elephants, which is, if you look at this as well, the I think 4 or 5 big animals, elephants, some smaller ones, but still they decide not to get into a fight or a tussle and just move. But now, of course, the elephants, they're probably a bit agitated, and it looks like they're taking it out on the smaller guys here. I was trying to edit it shorter, but I decided actually to just to leave it run a little bit for a couple of minutes, as it's quite interesting, that interaction. So also, I'll be quiet for a bit and just watch it with you. I can't get, I've watched it 10 times, but I can't get enough of watching this. And finally, I think the warthogs get the message. They are not wanted there. The elephants have reigned supreme, I guess. Porch match. In slow motion. Put your foot out. Swing it back in. Yeah. So, yeah, I was there, was on my way out of Edo, and it's really, I find it a fascinating thing. Is the elephants, it's like they're agitated by the fact that this one buffalo actually managed to scare them, and then they start taking it out on the little guys. It reminds me of, you know, schoolyards in primary school where you get bullied and then you take it out on somebody smaller than you. But anyway, it's interesting. As I said, I'm definitely now the next week's going to keep an eye on, maybe you could as well, on when you watch the waterhole and you see, let's say, getting to drink first, or whether other animals keep a different, keep a little distance in that sense. So yeah, it's interesting. If you just watch animals, every time you see something new. And yeah, with that, that ends today's episode and ends the first season. Because it's the end of the first season, I'm not going to ask you a viewer challenge, because I'm not sure exactly yet what the next first episode of the new season. We will be back, definitely. There will be a couple of weeks, I think. October 6th, 3 o'clock Central African time, we'll start with a brand new season. There will be some changes in the format, I think. Hopefully improve, contain more photo and video content, a bit like already this episode. All the animals that we live among. So with that, I want to thank you all for watching the first 4 episodes. And as I said, any feedback is welcome. And with that, I'm going to say goodbye. Tomorrow I'm going to go on my leave for about 10 days. And I'm already looking forward to starting the second season. Thank you for watching. And hope to see you all next season, October 6th, 3 o'clock Central African time.